each other.
Yeah.
I think there were two things, I guess, that I was hoping viewers would get. I mean, you can't control what people take out of it. They can take out anything. But one was that people like Plum can see themselves in, reflected in popular culture, which I think doesn't happen very often, or if it does, it's in a very dehumanizing way, like Shallow Hal and Fat Monica from Friends and that kind of thing. So to see, like, I see all the comments on social media saying, like, I've never seen myself on TV before, and that's really meaningful. And I think also, I hope it can teach some people empathy for people that are different from them in whatever way, and to really kind of think about what it's like to be in another person's shoes. So those are the two hopes that I have.
I mean, I've said recently, I think that, you know, writers who put their whole soul into this, they want to create empathy machines. You know, we're building machines that make empathy. And there's a moment in the book where, you know, Saray writes about Plum's character answering a question about what's the difference between a woman in a burqa and a woman in a bikini, you know, woman, and you know, Plum's answer is they're sort of, you know, different sides of the same coin in a way. They're both symbols of oppression. And to me, being an anorexic and having to live in a body that people don't think is acceptable are two sides of the same coin. They're both, you are having to respond to a kind of oppression every single day as a woman. And you know, if your body doesn't match what people say it should look like, then you spend your entire life with a narrative in your head that tells you you've lost the entire game and you're worthless. And I felt that way inside. So we're sisters, not, you know, we're twins.
We're sisters, not twins. Sisters, not twins. Thank you so much.